We go then to Victor in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, watching on YouTube. I was going to say we're going to calls, but watching on YouTube. But this is a call, Nick, right? Okay, so Victor, you are on with Dr. Chesankos. What's your question?
Thanks for taking my call. So I know that with a lot of atheists and with some Christians, they separate science and religion. And like, for instance, with my wife, she's strongly against evolution. And with me, I don't have a problem with evolution, but come to a point where I can't really talk to her about it. My question is it to the point where people have an inaccurate view of God? They think of God so small, or put him in the box, they think that God won't allow things like evolution or the Big Bang?
Yes, and I sympathize very much with your position there. And I think you're wise just to kind of let it go and love your wife and let her find her own way there. But yes, you're exactly right. It's just thinking of God as too small. And that's something we do, I think, as humans, because sometimes we just can't believe it. We just can't get there and think about it. But as far as evolution goes, like, this actually breaks my heart a little bit. People have been taught for a long time that there is evolution and then there is everything you learn in catechism class, and that the two are so totally separate. And if you believe evolution, you're turning your back on your faith. And I actually respect people who care so much about their faith that they won't even do that, because you can get through life without knowing evolution and you'll be fine. But the question then to challenge there, it's okay, because God created everything. God created the heaven and the earth. He made you and me and everything. And if living bodies evolved over time, then God created them to do that. There's nothing to ever worry about. I mean, scientists are going to go out and roll up their sleeves and discover what they can discover and come up with theories, and theories are going to be amended and new discoveries are going to be made, and science is going to keep going, and science has been wrong a million times before. But there's no problem believing that bodies evolved over time. We can never deny the soul, but there's no problem at all in wondering how, from non-living matter, did the first living thing arise, and then how did human beings arise over all those years? How did the diversity of life arise? If anything, you just go, wow, like, how did this happen? How did God do all of this? And you can spend your life asking that question, and it is very big. But fundamentally, I mean, we're made of atoms. Life came from atoms. We don't have to worry about denying our faith to believe that. Just pray the first line of the creed and mean it.
Thank you very much for that, Victor. We appreciate that call.